So, green white, Toski control style kind of deck. A lot of tokens built into this one, I think. Life gain, pretty key. Prosperous Innkeeper is great because it's life gain and the treasure token can give you turn three. Ramp, Felidar Retreat, Toski, Green Warden early is nice. You just start recasting some of your lands. Recast lands from your graveyard for late Scoot Swarms is pretty nice. Toski survives. Snakeskin Veil is nice for two things. A, point removal. B, getting Coven on Augur of Autumn. Being able to cast creatures off the top of your library is nice. Lands is nice. It's basically draw a card. Creature lands finish a lot of games where they exile your squirrel. Shambling Gas. That's a different game. What's the one? Mana Black. Shambling Gas. -1/-1 sucks. Toski's bad against that, so if you're playing against them, take them out. Let's put it in the field. There, it does have a sideboard. We're going to play some best of three here, because Platinum Life. Extra Hole. Commando. These are actually good against control decks as well as early flash 3-1 threat attacking on turn 3. If you play a hammer on turn 3, flashing this on turn 2, you are swinging with a 5-5. It's pretty nice. Faithful Absence is good. Doom Scars if you want to go more controlling. Tangled Trap. Redain for treasures and stuff. Intrepid Adversary is basically Cathartic Commando with the potential for board anthem effects and sick light gain. Intrepid Adversary with Maul of the Skyclaves feels real good. So, and we get to cast green and white spells, so I'm excited about that. So, traditional standard ranked Toski tokens. So this is a more token-focused version of the deck, for sure. I've been playing around with a couple various variations. One's more controlling. This is the token version of the deck, with cards like Catilda and Join the Dance. The other deck focuses more around playing the Chariot and Renan 7 with Storm the Festival. Storm the Festival can also grab you a Maul of the Skyclaves and a Toski at once, which puts them both into play. And immediately equips, which is nice. This is really good. I have a one of. I had a two of at one point, but the options on this card are nice right now. Gain life, destroy enchantment, exile a card from a graveyard. Those are all decent effects to have. And a 1/3 body is a-okay. There he is. There's my boy. So, yeah. Interesting. Okay. Expecting Deadly Dispute, expecting Eaten Alive, expecting Eye Twitch, expecting Shambling Ghast. Do it. There's the Deadly Dispute, that's probably a 4 of in every black red treasure deck. What's they're looking for. That works for me. I'm alright with that. Okay. Don't really want to do anything with that yet, so sadly, it's nothing to. I don't like playing Skeet Swarm without being able to also play a land. And ideally, Skute Swarm is a turn 6 play, or a land drop number 6 play, because I don't like seeing that. Need that card draw. Let's get some removal. Borrow time. All the Skyclaves. Another land. Lands are fine. We're just gonna bump these guys up. We're just gonna start. The Mushroom Predator is very strong. It's pretty cool. Vampire Dragon. It's good times. Borrowed time or ball the Skyclave. What? He's gonna die either way. I need to draw a card, so I don't want to invest counters when the damage isn't really gonna matter. I'd rather have another body next turn that will become a problem for these 4/4s. I'm gonna play the Green Warden next turn, and that'll shut down the air for a bit, and then I can bring Skute Swarm and start recasting lands to some pretty solid effect. That's a really nice draw. I'm gonna be able to kill one of these next turn. I'll play a Skute Swarm into land instead, and I'll be able to kill one of these. And I can discard a Dawnbringer Cleric, or I can kill the Immerstrom Predator. I probably won't do that because they will be able to. Well, then they'd sacrifice it. That might be the better call, actually. Let them pick. I need to make sure I keep enough creatures, though. If they remove a creature in response to Kabira Takedown, it doesn't actually kill them. So, discard a card is fine. That's less than ideal. That's definitely not what I wanted to see. Kabir Takedown sucks now. Eight in the air. That's fine. Shambling Ghast? No? We're not there yet. Cool. You have to exile your own graveyard now. That's fine. 1/1 counters are worth. Gonna have to go Green Warden, I think. Man. Oh. Nice. Let's try this again. All right, try that again. A bit better prepared for the flying 8/8s that are going to be appearing, apparently, with Ward. This is nice. One, two, three. Feels good. Nice, clean, open. Oh, love it. So Catilda into this would be worse. This way I am playing her into having two mana to tap, which is better. I should have played Lair, that was silly. Turn three. Yeah. It's so strong. I'm thinking about artifact decks that can play around with that. Probably not in standard, but historic might be able to have some fun with green, white, treasure, all the glitters, tempered steel. Man. Turn four Ancient Green Warden. Feels pretty cool, doesn't it? Magic Missile is not going to kill that, so. Great card. I think. Oh, man. Okay. Board white. Cinderclasms kind of thing, maybe? I'm not sure. That would be less than ideal for me. I think the Thieves' Tool is for Florian, Wilderin, Dude Bro. It's a neat deck. I have a version of this that plays mediocrely. I don't have a Westvale Regent, a Westgate Regent rather, and I'm not spending rare wild cards on a maybe kind of sort of. Okay. Toss would be stunning, but I think I took that, didn't I? This is also really good because I'm gonna gain all the life now. Look at that. All the life. Don't need to block when you can just kill, right? Okay, so now we start super pumping the team. It's gonna be good. Twenty-one damage, brew. Woohoo! That feels nice. Close it out. Close it out. All right, we were having a good time there. Interesting. Going wide will probably be the thing they're investing in single large threats. If I can go wide and gain life, I'll be fine. I don't. This might suck. We're both off on our mana, but he's got treasure, and I have yet to get treasure. That's upsetting. Shoot. Shoot, shoot, shoot. Yeah, I'm done with this one personally. Let's try that again. So, the mana is actually pretty good in the deck. I just have this happen sometimes because I keep hands that suck. So, don't keep hands that don't have Elkoza of mana, I think, unless you have Prosperous Innkeeper, because even though it is statistically unlikely, every time you keep a hand with only one of your colors, you aren't going to draw the other one, because fuck you, that's why. Magic the Gathering. Load. Slowbot. Okay. Try again. Blazing boys, this is great. 1, 2, 3. Right. 1, 2, 3. And I think this is the correct play here, because I think we'll get to a faster maul that way. These are mana now. I have 3 extra mana created when we play these two. 4. God, that's nice, isn't it? That was an error. If I played her first, I wouldn't have had to spend the treasure, so I kind of screwed myself out of, Five health. Whew, damn. What a piss off that is, eh? Devil should play Care of the Frost Dragon. That was really silly. I was thinking I was going to play Join the Dance when I played it, so I should have taken just an extra second there. Celestis. Turn. Book. Bot. Not sure what they think they are gonna do. One mana. Cast a spell. There you go. You got two mana now. Can you do anything with it? You should have like a blitz magic. You literally, like, are you casting Opt, Consider, another Fading Hope? Don't play the land first. Yeah, goof. They're just like, well, play my land. First thing I do, I return. It's like, but what if you actually thought about it? Exiled. Now, they might have enough mana. Maybe they're happy with that. That's fine. I've done that. However, kill him. Okay. 5-turn clock. Not good enough. Okay. Scorching Dragon, Fading Hope. 1 and 2. If they played faster, it'd be nicer, but these people who just get the deck. Okay. Cinderglasm's gonna wreck me. But if they don't cast it, I'm gonna start putting counters on everybody, and then it won't be a problem. So I really don't want this to be Cinderglasm. And Storm's Wrath would suck. Burn down the house would suck as well. But that's what we're dealing with. But he went to 14 though. Okay. That's the mistake. I'm going to attack and draw four cards now. Okay, stabilizing. Could have kept the land in hand to do Skeet Swarm next turn. That probably would have been smarter. I think I want to go Augur of Autumn into potential Skeet Swarm, though. Maybe get some lands off the top of the deck. Cotilda will give me a bunch of mana. I'm waiting for this giant to start being a problem. The card back blends into the library there, which is annoying. But I luckily have the actual problem hammer that they apparently forgot about, so. Twenty-seven to eight. Has to discard the Epiphany. I probably have a giant coming at me. I can throw a bug in front of it though. Or I can just take it, because I have 27 life and I'm gonna gain more. The board wipe is the problem at this point. Toski will live though. It's all damage base. There we go. Sorry, Blazing Boy. All right, spells. Let's say less of that stuff. Don't need you. It's mostly tokens. Wouldn't mind getting rid of that. Got some options, got some things to try, got some stuff that may or may not be good. Let's find out. Toski, Toski. Shitty openers are always upsetting. Okay, we'll make it work. Gonna ditch probably. So, I just keep screwing myself over here, don't I? That was the worst land to play in the opener. Gotta love it when Paolo comes out to play. He's a helpful friend to have in times of need. Not a fan. I'm gonna get rid of your leader then. Sorry, friend. Okay. You don't have to. You can kill. To rest to get one of these. Rough. One mana shy, because I screwed up in the opening. Devastating. Misplays. Brought to you by some do play magic. Turn the land into a creature and then make the creature count tap itself for yeah, it's good times. God, there's so many of this freaking card. That's a bummer. Oh no, there they go. They can do it anyway. Leader's real good, huh? I've got two of them. I would like to get more of them before I try and do any of this Grixis shenanigans, but I'm intrigued by, Get your lands. Huh, there it is. Has to block the Hydra unless he has power word kill to kill my Hydra. When he blocks one of them, it takes one damage. Oh, turns one. So many cards in hand, and they're still so. Cast burn down the house again. Do it. Fucking hell. It just gets a little tedious, doesn't it? View the battlefield. So, nothing in play though, this is the thing. Two down. Got a 4-2 lifelinker. It's gonna be a 6-4 lifelinker. Thank you. 5-3-7-5. Unless this is also. There it is. Tap out. Good boy. Let's draw some cards. Desperation. It's a cool deck though. I want to get, when I get some more mythics, I'm going to get some Leer and start pumping out this sort of thing. Seems like fun. If I could get the rares for Magda, I would also try out the Team of Treasure deck. It seems like cool, rampy, Jaspera Sentinel and Prosperous Innkeeper. Fun stuff. Giving me a card, really? I'll take it. I'll take the card, bud, but you don't really need to give me one like that, I don't think. Do you know? Two cards. The last Auron's Epiphany. Every bird is in play. have no graveyard hate in this deck, which is a mistake on my part. Could have gotten rid of all of this, but any graveyard hate whatsoever in this deck, and that's the problem. Trade off. I have 12 minutes on this player, and I want to smack them in the face because, are you serious? Keep saying good game, bro. It's still been good game like four times. They have 7 minutes to my 18 and a half. Four cards in hand. Seven there, you have three mana. Potentially four. Five mana. Looking for another Leer, perhaps. Looking for a board wipe. Looking for exile, discard. Board wipe will not finish Toski. This is why this deck is possible. Double removal spell. Kills both my ghosts. Gains me some life though, and lucky me, Toski's actually a 3-3, so you have one mana? I'm gonna beat you down with my little the one life gain though. Luckily I have a Frost Dragon, so it really doesn't matter, but I've taken 2 minutes and they've taken five. I'm gonna double use the Celestis. I'm gonna be attacking for six. Why we don't say it 20 minutes for the game is over. Alright, well hey, wasn't that fun? Gotta love it. I'm gonna take a break because I need to pee. You know how it is. We'll be back shortly with some other stuff. this up. Instead of that, let's try. Dragons. Horrible hole, maybe. We'll see what happened. Could be bad, could be good. I'm okay with this. At least that was better than that. Man, I would love it. Can't have that. No, thank you. I want it better. That's upsetting. Peace. Love that, eh? Last pool mimic makes another dragon. Yeah, that's pretty great. Done that the other way around. Ah well, to them, into your hand. Pretty all right, I gotta say. Swinging in with the man. Ew. Take it. I'll take it. I'll take it. I'll take it. Life gain, etc. Gonna keep it as it is, I think. Feels a little bit better. Bow, bow, bow. Nissa.
Oh, Nissa.
Mega Mark 22. Ah, it's always upsetting. That's better. Please be a 3 drop. Okay. Well, if I have 2, I really want to be able to 4 for Unexpected Windfall. That's fair. I'm okay with this. Let's go get a Montan. Deck fitting. Tap out. Tap out. Nice. Love it. Okay, so if he plays it, I exile it. Play something else, I can counter it. Say yes. You can try. That's a bit annoying. Not that one. No, it'll be okay. If there's no creatures in play, and none in his graveyard, then it doesn't matter that this exists, even, so. And if I can do... Getting there. So close. 4 drop. Ah, 4 drop. Anything, really. There it is. Counterspell says no. I've got the birdies in the trees on my tongue. Get rid of one of those removal spells for creatures that aren't there. No. Okay. I'd like to draw some cards, please. Other cards, thank you. Hope he plays something that I can kill. That was a mistake. The treasure would have been 3 beforehand, so I could have made a second dragon right away. And now I lose my dragon because of bad. This is fine. We're going to divide by 0 the next thing and then kick ass. It'll be good. Whatever you do, friend. Sorry, nope. Not into that noise. We're gonna go get Mascot. Makes it hard to try stuff when people concede like that. I'll get this list up as well, I guess, because this isn't the green white list from earlier. This is just dragons. Y'all know dragons. It's blue red dragons. I'm not any. It's almost exactly Yuta Takahashi's list from the World Championship, so it's not particularly unique. So we do Toski control. This is a green white list. It's kind of fun. It's less token based, more removal board by board control state. It's neat. Three, four, five, three, four, five, three, four, five. Crazy, but it's possible. We'll see how aggressive their open is. But I'm feeling confident. Come on, man, you have one land in play. I haven't done anything yet. Hello? Thank you. Like, Nate. Four seconds, minute 15 to play one land. Interesting. So good. So good. Yeah, take them away. Red or Chariot or Felidar, any of them. I'm happy with all of them. Works for me. Do a friend, no priest. Okay. Nice. I'll take the 2 health. Sure. Cool. Like, he's indestructible, you know? Next turn I can go Skew Swarm into Snow and to get everyone with their counters, everyone with their bodies, and then just start smashing, really. Fair. Yeah, we just go into full control and I'll be able to activate it in response to the 1-1 counter trigger. Seven damage. Draw four cards. No complaints here, friends. This version of the deck, I think it might be stronger because I'm playing the good cards that other people are playing. Go figure. I like the tokens version. I think the tokens version is a budget version of the same kind of list. It has a different approach. It still goes wide. It's still powerful. Cool, let's win this turn then, because, duh? I don't understand. Was I supposed to be upset by that? Yeah, I don't know what they were hoping would happen there. Black. Removal spells, duress, I don't like a lot. A little more mid-rangey, get some bodies down so I can get rid of a Death Touch threat with a Skyclave Apparition and then block a non-Death Touch threat with the same thing. Hopefully get two removals out of it, basically. I don't think I want to go for Wrath of God style play. This is upsetting. That's better. Cool. We're gonna go for Augur into Felidar as quick as we can. That's annoying. It's just hungry for more, eh? Hungry for more is kinda like Lightning Helix in black red. Interesting. Okay. Am I expecting them to do it again? Question mark. Just keep on slamming with these three ones. Kind of wild. It's very powerful. It's not bad at all. Like, this is creating a huge disadvantage for me. Now we can start making blockers, though. We can start creating bodies, hopefully, if I get Prosperous Innkeeper, Lunar Veteran. I don't think I run Lunar Veteran in through the deco, but Prosperous Innkeeper definitely is in the deck. I'd like to manage some of these guys. I want to not be dealing with these freaking vampires. These guys are great. These guys are so. Ugh. Just pew pew pew. Knock it down. Staying alive. I'll still take 2 damage from it, but I would die. Is that any point, really, I guess? Saves 1 point of damage. That's fair. Okay. Got them back down to my level, though. So I want to actually crew the cat to make a cat token. That's some extra value there. The 2/2s each turn would be very nice. This is interesting now. I'm not sure where they're gonna push with this, but the battlefield make a cat. I don't really want to do this. I really wish I had the mana. Make the trade, I'm left with 10 in play, which will be lethal. it's so annoying. I mean, they're just taking it, so that's fine, but I hate when it gives you the other land like that. That's annoying. Rank up. Rank up! Into it. That's a nice little version of that deck. I feel like that's probably better. Cough, cough, cough. I would like a Leer, please. Store. Depends, you can't get packs on packs. Hello. There we go. Oh yeah, golden. Oh, okay, cool, good job, me. Let's play some Phoenix. I shouldn't have to use rare cards to get Faithless Looting, a repeatedly printed common card. It's a cash grab for fake paper, digital cardboard. So I bought actual cards instead. And slowly but surely build out the cards online. Let's have a good time. well. Thank you. Those are absolute trash hands. Damn. Probably some lines I need to hit there, but that was just rough. So, taking a look. This Phoenix list. Bats, eh? Minnesota or otherwise? Turn four. Five lands. Dragons don't care, bro. I do like Phoenix. Phoenix is a fun time. So let's just play some. Let's draw it for a better thing. I'm trying to clock what my sideboard will be in Phoenix. So. Fabled because I want to get lands in the graveyard. I want the types for Delirium, which is really key with Dragon's Rage Channeler. Otherworldly Gaze is really good. I'm thinking it's maybe a 4 of, and maybe I'm ditching an Opt. Opt feels crazy to get rid of, but then I guess it's expressive. I want the 1 ofs over the 2 ofs, I think. I like the idea of Ox. I think maybe it's dead more often than it's helpful. Maybe it's more of a sideboard and midi style matchups. We'll see. Devil's Play. That's kind of dirty, isn't it? Damn. Just X damage. Loot, loot, kill thing, quick. Maybe one box, one Torment script. Cool. Let's traditional historic ranked chess guy edit deck. What's the one card in it that's banned? 1, 2, 3, 4. So annoying. Okay. Jeskai's neat, Jeskai's nifty. We're gonna play Phoenix though. I've been hearing good things. Well, there'll be people playing started playing quicker than these people playing standard. Well, 15 minutes ahead on somebody is pretty crazy. That's mine. Alright, let's take over and win the game now. Hey, they just don't like the dragon, do they? Okay. That early land in the graveyard for the McMulligan. This is good. I'm gonna find everything I want right away. That's good, because that'll help me, I think, more than it'll help them. We know what we're playing, so I'm just gonna get my cards down. Normally I wouldn't until I'd in first game I would do it at the end of their step, first turn. So, vampires, death triggers. I'm expecting the Famished Paladin Sorcerer's Wand combo in the deck,